No, I think it'll be fine. I tested it before. Okay. It's set to automatically record.
What?
Tell everyone on chat to get their butts in here, cause it's time! Yes!
And Sunbro is, Greg.
Oh, yeah. Alright, so, humans! Stream
Hello.
Is live! We have all zero of you, apparently, but... I'm going to start and assume that you're all here. So welcome back, my delicious human friends, to the Plays the Thing with me, Joe.
And me, Corey.
We have names now. The internet knows. This was a mistake. But, so, Corey.
Yes.
What did we do last time on Dragon Ball Z?
we did the tutorial.
We did the tutorial. And so now we're not going to do the tutorial. We're going to do the actual game.
Yes, we're starting the actual game.
Yes, good.
In our little apartment.
In our little apartment. Well, let's... Oh, God. Let's load the game. And who is Dare?
Oh, Jamila is here.
Oh, hello, Jamila. How are you? We have six humans watching. Four more.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah. So, we are here in our apartment.
Yes.
Do we want to explain how we got here to the human citizens, or...
Yeah.
Okay.
Do I have... Okay.
Yeah.
So, how the game starts, for anyone who missed it, is you are embraced or turned into a vampire by someone, and then immediately... your life is threatened, or your undeath.
You are stabbed in the damn chest.
Yes. Apparently, you were turned into a vampire, I guess, illegally, essentially.
Yeah.
And they were considering killing you for that. They killed the person who turned into a vampire, and there was some weird power dynamics that were going on there, and eventually... The prince, who seems to be the person in charge, decided, no, you get to live, but we have to do some work for him, which is why we are here now. We have to meet an agent of his called Mercurio, and get stuff done.
Yeah. So, I have a thing about this room that was only pointed out to me the other day by
yes.
Tom.
Okay.
When we were, like, prepping for the stream and I was playing back through the game to remember shit to talk about. This right here. These wooden boards.
Yeah.
Why?
Because the floor probably has a hole?
No. Because there are windows and you're a vampire. It's for boarding up the windows during the daytime.
That's kind of awesome.
Yeah, and in fact, if you look at by the your bed, the windows...
It's already boarded.
Yeah, so it's like a visual storytelling.
Very
also,
interesting.
Things we can tell about the room. Someone was here before us.
Yes.
Someone human, because it's like a whole shit ton of pizza. But they also knew that we were a vampire, because there's blood.
Yes.
In the fridge. Like you do.
Take it all.
Yes. Let's take this. Oh, there's more.
Yeah, there are three.
All right. So, let us examine all these things. Hey, the password for your computer is Sunrise. Keep the cash in the drawer. It's yours. I dropped you an email with my address. Come over after you get settled. Mercutio.
Mercurio.
Mercurio.
It's close.
The money envelope. Take it. I like to imagine there was just a single $100 bill in that envelope. At your convenience, please come and visit me in my home downtown. I leave you this guide. Dark blood, our curse. I like this verse. Such power I sense in one so young. Come find me where burns the mystical sun. M. Strauss, Tremere Regent. So, this is a person that we have not met to this point, for those playing at home. And so, okay, there has been a living person in here, perhaps it's Mercurio. There has been a person who we think is probably a vampire here, who knows we were here, like, who knows we were supposed to be here before we knew we were supposed to be here.
Yep, and this person seems to be pretty official because of the monogram.
Yeah, the monogrammed letterhead, like, letterhead. and Computron. What does our Computron say about us? Jezebel at home.
Oh yeah, that's what we named her.
That's right. Oh, password. Sunrise. One. A reminder. A reminder. From LaCroix. Mercurio will contact you when you arrive in Santa Monica. Waste no time in meeting with him. SL. Next. Dang! It's big, you know.
Yeah.
Hung low at trojanbotnet.vtm. Penis enlargement. Watch the girls come running. Call today. Kilpatrick's crime pewter. Looking for that lazy ass ex-husband who's late on his alimony payments? How about that jerk who knocked you up? Look no further. With Arthur Kilpatrick's amazing crime pewter, you can find almost anyone with a record. And these days, that's just about everyone. So come on down to Arthur Kilpatrick's bail bonds. If you've got the deadbeat, we've got the technology to find him.
I just noticed that the email is .vtm.
Oh yeah, that's most emails.
I didn't even notice that before.
That last email, I think, is important, and remember that Arthur Kilpatrick email. It's going to come up later.
And the dick one.
Does it?
No.
I thought there was just some obscure Easter egg in this. So, hey, welcome to town. Come on, from Mercurio. Hey, welcome to town. Come on over to my place. Once you get situated, and we'll talk about what you'll need to get the job done. I'm going to pick up the explosives right now. Some Astrolite. I should be back by the time you come over. I'm at 24 Main Street, in number 4. Walk to the end of the alley, and my building is the next one on the right, M. So,
Mercurio's, like, he really wants you to know he was there. He left you an email and a note. On paper.
Yeah. He's eager to please. And another email from a friend. The game begins. A pawn is moved. Much like the Kilpatrick email, this will come up again in the future. So,
you don't put something like that if it's not important.
No.
Like, random spam.
I mean, hey. Games have done worse. Alright, so let's get out of here. Let's interact with some of these things. TV?
Many biologists that have examined the monster have commented that they have never seen anything like it in the cephalopod family before. They speculate that it could be from a yet undiscovered family of sea creatures. A massive gelatinous creature that washed up on the beaches of Providence, Rhode Island, has scientists scratching their heads, found by a jogger early on.
And?
Hello, LA. You're up way past your bedtime, aren't you? Hope
yes.
You slipped into something comfortable. I know I have. If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to The Dell of Night. The only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one?
So,
let's see.
Deb.
Yes.
Who could be the lucky caller? You've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb.
Yes.
Let's leave it there, because Deb's things get a little long. But Deb, we have theories about Deb.
Yes, we do. But I think we should not really go into them so in-depth yet.
No? Okay.
Deb is a...
recurring radio personality.
Yes. And if you listen to the radio throughout the game, she will have... there will be different episodes of her show. And it kind of goes along with the story and things that happen in the game and current events. And basically she's just the night disc jockey. And she has a lot of weird people call into her show.
Yes, that is true. That is accurate.
Lady, you got some change, lady?
I do. So I'm gonna give him the change.
Go ahead.
Yeah, unless.
Be nice.
Yeah, I'm gonna be nice. Where's the change?
Four.
Four here. It's not much, but I hope it helps.
Just very nice. Thank you.
Ah, oh, that's so nice. So humanity. This. Construction.
Oh no.
Oh no. So, let's follow that lead before we talk about a few things.
Okay.
At least I have a few things to talk about.
I do too.
Yes. So let's follow the guy. Blood and... Look at that. Number 24. That smells like plot to me.
So that was some pretty obvious game design.
Yeah.
There, where you're obviously supposed to follow him.
I mean, a little ham-fisted.
Yeah.
But I actually think there's more subtle things at play there that I will mention as soon as we finish the scene. And I'll mention stuff about this room when we get there. A corpse. A moving corpse.
Those mothers ripped me off. I'm dying here. Oh. Yeah. You looking for the astrolite? I can feel a draft on my fucking insides. They shanked me, the bastards. The blood ain't working no more. My head, it feels cracked. Oh, I think my eyes popped.
What do you want to say?
Number one.
What is this lump? Is this my rib? Oh, holy shit, my rib is poking through my side? Oh, I'm all numb. You gotta look and tell me.
It's a broken bottle.
Yes.
Goddamn chemist. Can't trust any operators in L.A. I verified him. Organizations seem reliable. Guy mixes up speed. His crew sells it. Occasionally does explosives. I set up a drop. I show up at the beach with the money, right? Four of his guys, they come out of nowhere. Junkie pricks. Hit me with a bat. It feels like I got a friggin' horse kicking it. I never should have gone alone. Amateur move. I should have handled those pricks. Goddamn dirty Cali rat bastards. Those cocksuckers beat me rotten, left me for a stiff. I had to crawl to my car, crawl my ass up here. The vamp blood's the only thing holding me together. But shit, they got the money, they got the astrolite.
Number four.
Right, you're straight off the bus. Once a month I get fed vampire blood. Heals me faster, makes me stronger than a normal human. I don't age. By looking at me, you wouldn't realize it, but I'm almost 60.
Wow.
Yeah.
Looks good.
He's a golden oldie. So, where do I find the Astrolite?
Mm-hmm.
Those small-time sons of bitches live out in a dump on the beach. Four or five of them. The one's got the explosives is Dennis. Got my money too, that prick.
How do I get it back?
Here.
You gotta get it back from him. Maybe reason with him, maybe break in. I don't know. I wanna kill him. Do whatever you people do. I blew it, I know.
Is there anything else I can do to help you?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you could... Oh, something just started leaking. I need something for the pain. One more thing. About the deal. I mean it. You tell anyone about this, I'm dead. I'm begging you. I got a way of getting people what they need. You don't say anything, I can help you out.
Okay.
Good to know. And he's dead.
Then he's back to being dead. So, things we learned in this scene. Well, what do you have thoughts about this room and Mercurio specifically? I still want to call him Mercutio so bad.
Mercurio seems pretty well off.
Yeah. He's got sweet digs.
You can see the story that's told through this room. Like, when you look, he came in. He turned the light on, stumbled over the table, and went to lie on the couch.
I think, does he have any other stuff in this room? I can't remember if he had...
No, I don't think so.
No, he doesn't. Okay. It's one of the other neighbors. But, on top of that, yeah, like you said, the visual story told with blood to the door, leans on the door, like, all pretty standard video game narrative stuff. But... subtle point to LaCroix is rich because his servants hang out in places like this.
Yep.
Our FPS drops whenever we load. Good to know. Oh, back up and back down and back up again. There we go. But, other thing, I kinda like about that scene is when we start over here, like, they do kind of ham-fist us into the whole, like, he's over there. But if you walk out of here, and that scene were not to exist, you have this place in front of you. You have, basically no conceivable action. This crashed car kind of draws your attention out to the sidewalk. And... forces you down the street where the, like, next major, like, point of interaction is here. And, oh, hey now, that's where I have to be. I mean, I think they could have had a little more confidence in their design and not, like, really ham-fisted it there, but I think that works.
I agree. Do you have anything more to say about that scene specifically?
Yes. Mercutio's language.
Yes. Okay.
He, speaks, as though he's from New York.
Yeah.
Or the stereotype of New Yorkers.
Yep. And he, solidifies that with calling these people Cali rat bastards.
Yep.
You're in California. So it implies that he's not from California.
Yep. And it also implies that he's old. Because no one...
says rat bastards?
No one says rat... No one talks the way he does, is the euphemisms he uses, and Cali rat is a really old insult. That's like back when it was actually a bad thing to be from California.
Yeah. And we also learned something about him. I guess you can move this way.
Yeah. We learned something about him. Also, great telegraphing. If we were nice to Mercutio and we're like, hey, let's help you out. Boom, hospital.
Yep. Go get the stuff to help him.
Yeah.
So go to the front door of the hospital.
Hey, how's it going, girl?
Oh, this guy's talking to us now.
Do I know you? I'm okay. Do I know you?
Oh, man, wait. Say that again.
Okay, do I know you?
Oh, man, you're a vampire, aren't you?
And you know you're supposed to keep this secret. Why is this guy asking this of you?
Yeah, and this also is kind of like a test of how close you've been paying attention to the game so far.
Yeah.
Which I like. I'm going to say, what? Vampire? What the hell are you smoking?
Come on, you are too! Oh man, don't bullshit me, girl. Just come clean. I ain't gonna tell no one. It's okay. I just wanna talk.
Alright.
Hell yeah! Oh man, I knew it! Oh jeez, I knew you were! I just could tell! Oh man, this is great! And I saw your teeth in it, and I was like, damn, it was like I could just sense you. The name's Knox Harrington. Pleasure to meet you.
Oh, man. Are you a vampire?
I'm a ghoul. I didn't know about any of this stuff until a couple of months ago. And this guy just appeared and, well, all of a sudden, bam! Whoa, man! Vampires are real and right there in front of my eyes! Blew my goddamn mind.
What's a ghoul?
Well, the way it was explained to me, whenever a vampire lets a human drink some of their vampire blood, the human gains a little vampire power. Can heal up quick and that kind of stuff. Jeez, oh man. Then they're a ghoul. Ooh, watcha.
Watcha.
Two or one?
One.
Oh man, I really wish I could tell you, but I don't think I'm supposed to. But it's really cool to be talking to you, just, well, because I don't get a lot of chance to talk to vampires, oh man! Other than my master, so I thought I'd just say, you know, what's up, you know?
Oh, Knox.
It's awesome! Man, after that first date of vampire blood, it's like the best drug. Oh man, I'm telling you, it's like, well, it didn't mess me up. Just made me feel like I was better at everything. Felt like a god just sucking on that nasty dude's wrist. Look, I probably shouldn't tell you this, but I want a secret mission for my master. Well, hey! Ha, it's been great talking to you, man. But I better be going. Oh, man! You know, important stuff to do.
Sorry. So.
Knox.
We've met two ghouls so far.
Yeah.
Both of them seem kind of odd.
A little odd, but different from one another as well.
Yeah.
And Knox has a vampire like logo on
his
shirt.
Yeah. And on the back of his shirt too.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
So let's get some medicine for Mercurio.
Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen.
Oh.
Did you hear me? Take a seat. The doctor will get to you when he can.
Let's say okay.
Okay. So, I like the way this game presents a reasonable because this is a real world challenge that you would face. It's not like a lot of video games will just let you wander around like places that you're not supposed to.
Yeah.
Particularly a lot of games from this era where it's just like, yeah, you can wander around, no one's gonna pay attention to you at all. In this case, a person actually responded to you as though they were a reasonable person.
And you can see that the hospital, like, everything seems to be kind of in disrepair, and that's just kind of the aura of the game.
Yeah.
But this hospital is also kind of obviously pretty packed right now.
It's packed, it's in disrepair. And the nurse pointedly says the doctor.
Yes.
Not doctors.
So, yeah. There's an implication there of being understaffed. So it's not like... It tells a story through the environment again.
Yeah, because this place looks shitty. Like, there's... You come in the door, there is a flashing light, there is a broken elevator, like a really atrociously repaired, badly broken one. A very angry, stressed out nurse. And
a lot of potential patients in the waiting room. It's not like there's no one there and she's like, I can't help you, I'm too busy.
Yeah.
It's pretty obviously busy.
So let's get through this. How are we gonna get through? Do you wanna do how shall we skin this cat?
Let's try presents.
Let's try presents.
It is one of the things we can use without breaking the masquerade.
Yeah. So we have powers that we can use when we're in an area where we have to look like we're human. And powers that we can't use for those that were not here last time. I'm going to attempt to use my presence and talk.
You can't go back there! Security!
Oh!
Security!
Oh, you went too far.
I went too far. Let's load this. Let's reload that. Professionals!
Oh, yes.
We're clearly professionals. So.
Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen. Please, wait your turn and you'll be seen. Did you hear me? Take a seat. The doctor will get to you when he can.
You could do number one.
Let's use our... Let us once again use presence, but this time in conversation.
Yeah.
To magic our way through.
All right.
But they need someone like me back there. And if you'll notice, that cost us a little bit on the side. That cost us a little bit of our blood meter, so not consequence free. So, room one. Let us try room one.
Please get a doctor.
Second person who's almost dead that we've seen.
We seem to find those people a lot. Busy day.
My insides, it hurts so bad.
Oh no. So we have to find her a doctor.
A doctor. Room three.
Here's a doctor.
I'm sorry, miss, but you're going to have to wait outside like everyone else. No exceptions. See here now, I'm the only physician here at the moment. We got twice as many people as usual waiting for treatment. I'll look at her as soon as possible. Try to talk to her, keep her awake. I've got a man in there with a bullet in his head. My nurse paged Dr. Roberts a half hour ago. He'd be here any time. Till then, stay with your friend and make sure she doesn't go into shock. I must go. How are his vitals?
Who's he asking?
Yeah, wow. Excellent game design. How are his vitals? I don't know. You tell me, pal. So now we face ourselves with a problem.
Yes.
A problem that we have been primed to solve a certain way.
Let us go through it and then discuss it afterwards.
Okay. How do you wish to skin the problem the expected way?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can someone call my grandma, please?
Oh, no. Maybe my blood can save you.
Yeah. I just noticed your character's eyes.
I know. Was that a humane thing to do?
You... Who are you? Oh, what did you do? What did you do to me?
Which one?
Three?
What does the audience say?
Nobody says anything.
Audience participation.
Nope.
Nope. Okay. So, we say... three.
But you did something. I kissed your wrist. I can feel it inside of me. What did you do?
Forget about it.
Forget about it. You're not supposed to talk about it.
I feel like I know you. Like you've always been here.
Goodbye.
Cargo. So, that happened.
So.
Oh.
Who are you? Can I help you with something?
Did she talk to you?
I just need...
I tried to close the door on her.
No.
Goodbye.
No.
So, I really like how they handled that situation. You can go through and look at all of the things
yes.
in this place. First you meet Mercurio, who is, who you find out is a ghoul. He's a human who knows about vampires, which you were led to believe wasn't a thing. You learned that he is very old, that he drinks vampire blood, and the vampire blood does something to him to make him that old. Also, that the vampire blood is the only thing keeping him together, even though he is very unwell.
He has many organs busted.
Yes. And then, if you are nice to him and you agree to get him medicine, you might have to blood buff for this.
Yeah. I'm going to probably go to the other room first.
You will, once you leave his apartment, you will see the hospital and go to the hospital to try to find a way to get him medicine. And once you reach the hospital, you are accosted by a man named Knox, who turns out is also a ghoul. And he tells you a little bit more about being a ghoul and how to do it, how you feed someone morphine. Not feed someone morphine, but...
feed someone vampire blood.
Feed someone vampire blood and they become a ghoul and they essentially become your servant. And he has someone who is his master, who he does stuff for. And then when you get into... when you... finally reach the inside of the hospital, which can be done in several different ways. You find yourself face to face with this woman who is very unwell.
Who's dying.
Yeah. And it's super pitiful and sad, and you have learned that you have the capability of saving her life with your blood. So you find yourself at that crossroads. Do you let her die, or do you give her your blood?
And that is a loaded decision, and I will point out why right now with my magic powers. Because it also primes you to doubt whether that's a good decision, because both Nox and Mercurio, to the modern viewer's eyes, act a little weird, particularly Nox.
Mm, yes.
Has a very, he doesn't act like a normal... there's a slight edge to him. It's like, is that normal behavior? Is he normal? And then he refers to blood as a drug.
Yes. And he says it's a drug that doesn't mess him up. but as you see how Mercurio acts about it, it seems that he is craving it and he wants it, because it is helping him feel better.
Mm-hmm. But a little help. A little help from Danny. Hey Danny, I could use a little help down here. Can you go up to Controlled Substance for some morphine? I'm pretty busy right now. F-Dog, yeah.
F-Dog.
No, it's not for my personal use, you bastard. I didn't know they were out upstairs. Maybe you can get me some in Malcolm's office. BTW, your mother wears combat boots. F-Dog. Oh shit, that's cold. But I'll make sure to knock before I go in. I'd hate to catch him in the middle of a pelvic examination. And by the way, tell your mom to stop calling me F-Tug. But, so, we learn that Malcolm, whoever this person is having sex with people in his office.
Yep.
And his office is where the morphine is. So we go hang out in the office. Where we got our morphine. Let's go into Malcolm's computer. I got an email. Strong bad emails. Panacea. Enter. Tonight. Malcolm, are you free tonight? I thought you could swing by my apartment after your shift. Do you still make house calls, don't you, doctor? I have something that needs to be checked out. Paige. Okay. So, sexual innuendo email, but also doctor.
Yep.
You have met one doctor before now.
Yep.
In this whole building. Do I have to ask twice? We don't have to do anything if you don't want it, but I really need some help studying for my anatomy test. Please, Paige. More sexual innuendo. Guess I'll see you around 5. I'm really glad you finally decided to come over, and if you should want me to show my appreciation, you just have to ask, Paige. Malcolm, do you think you'll be able to get day off next week? My mother's coming to town Thursday. Ah, this is from someone else, clearly not the person he is sleeping with in the other emails. That sounds like a significant other. Okay, so let's go to, let's quit this, and let's go to...
Patience.
Another password. Hippocrates. H. Poe. Heather Poe. Ruptured organs, lacerations, internal bleeding, condition critical. Hey, that's the person we just met.
A. Kilpatrick.
A. Kilpatrick, a name we have seen before.
Something about crime fighting.
Diagnosed severe tinea infection compounded by untreated herpes simplex 2.
Yep.
Yep. D. Marsh. Diagnosis: frequent bouts of sexlexia. M. Barber. So that's not a person named Paige.
No.
Diagnosis: chronic Marburitis, uncurable. I don't know what that is, but maybe I missed it somewhere in the emails. Enter. Yeah, the headlines of the emails: Ree thinks she's suspicious. The subject lines of the emails with someone called Paige: Ree thinks she's suspicious. If we go back out here to our doctor friend.
I told you, I will get to you when I can. Please take a seat.
You, Malcolm, your wife know about your affair?
Get out of here! Can't you see I'm with a patient? Are you trying to blackmail me? You don't know who my wife is. She wouldn't believe you. Now get out. Wait now. What do you want?
Well, something got
deal. But I'm in the middle of something. I'll have to drop it off later. never speak to me about that again.
So, I am reasonably sure that that is a method that you can use to get him to treat her. And that is kind of a note we hit on last time with
the most obvious way
is not necessarily the best way.
Yeah, may or may not. You don't really know what happened to Heather or what's going to happen.
Yeah. And we clearly risked violation of the masquerade, and this person is like, I feel like I've always known you. And yeah. It's like, oh.
She starts acting weird.
Oh, maybe this wasn't okay.
Nothing. Just waiting for a friend to get off work. He's a police officer. Old army buddy. He should be bringing his dog as well. It's a Rottweiler. Wonderful attack dogs they are.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah. I'm happily married to my work. And I have a wife, too. Afraid I'm a little short on cash right now. I'm so sorry.
Well, he doesn't seem to want to talk to you.
Yeah, he does not want to talk to us. So, we need to go to the beach.
Yes, and Mercurio told us that it was through the parking garage.
And I see parking garage things. So let's call it this way. Although, do you want to talk about feeding, or do you want to save that for later?
Oh, let's save that.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go there.
I've seen a lot of shocking things in my time on the force, but that pier, that's the kind of thing that makes you lose your faith in humanity.
I gotta say, it's the second worst thing I've ever seen.
Poor bastard down there is torn in two. By the looks of it, you'd think someone tied him to two horses and raced them in opposite directions. What could you have possibly seen that was worse than what's down there?
It was about 3 years ago when the Melody got his guy on the beach. Looked like, I don't know, an attack.
Shark bite?
Nah, seeing shark bites is something different. Whatever killed him, that was missing. And there were these huge slashes.
Bullshit.
No. Guy was literally slashed to ribbons. The worst part was I was waiting for the meat wagon. I felt like something was watching me. I swear on my badge today that there was something just out of sight. For a split second, I thought I wanted to get the squad car and get the hell out of that place. To this day, it makes me wonder what's really out there.
Maybe it was a werewolf. Woo! Or a vampire.
Yeah. See, this is why you didn't get invited to Hernandez's wedding, Ted.
Rough.
Yeah. Ted is a dick.
So, we've been learning... Did you look at the newspaper?
No, I didn't look at the newspaper. I forgot to look at the newspaper. But, through a newspaper that I forgot to pick up outside of our apartment, and through a mention on the news... on the TV that we didn't listen to. And I think Deb... Deb doesn't mention it.
I don't think so.
But we've been hearing about this murder, a murder most foul. And
The pier.
Yeah, on the pier. And if we've managed to miss all those things like we have, there's a conversation that happens like right here with a police taped off area and like all this
and
bullshit.
And it says pier, so it's obviously happened right there.
Yeah. And we hear about a murder that sounds weird. We've heard about two murders, actually.
Two?
Yes. One that this guy's like, man, that's the weirdest fucking body I've ever seen. And the other cop's like, nah, man, that's not the weirdest shit I've ever seen. Here's this other weird shit that I have seen. Mm. Both of those things sound like supernatural shit.
Yeah.
In fact, the dick cop makes a joke about it. We live here now. Under the stairs.
Good night. So we are continue on our way to get back the Astrolite, or get back the money, and get
the Astrolite,
period.
Any of those, any combination of those things.
Well, Astrolite is most important.
I think the money's important.
That's pretty important, yeah. The dick cop. That's right, Jamila. Oh, hello.
Up there. Through that chain-link gate and up those stairs. Those men you are looking for.
How
never
did you
mind.
Know?
You wouldn't understand.
Thanks? I just want look to your left and go up the stairs quickly. And if you look at the top of that cliff, there is a wolf that was hanging out there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
I actually hadn't noticed that one.
Yeah, that's one that I knew about. And, don't know. Was it just a wolf? Would there just be a wolf there? Or is it something more?
Let's find out.
Wow, they just let you get right up on it. So, if we had seen the newspaper article, we would have seen that the murderer has a picture of this corpse. So this is what everyone has been talking about.
A murder most foul, and some tired cops. Oh, that's a policeman. That's high. And get some liquid demon seed.
That sounds suggestive.
All of them indeed are, because this was 2004.
Okay, so we went like a little roundabout way because I wanted to show you something, but once you get out into the beach area, you are spoken to by that woman, and it is pretty obvious that the game is pointing you towards the campfire, because that's where the light is coming from, and that's where a bunch of people are congregated.
Well, and there's, like, when you see here, there's a wall visually directing you out towards a house over there in the distance.
And but there is also a ship in the distance, too.
Ah, yeah.
That might catch your eye at some point.
But, in the foreground, though, you've got a lot more busyness than on this whole side of the screen here. Because you have the woman, you have a campfire with people hanging around it, you have a door, some stairs up.
That are lit. The stairs are also lit.
Yeah, and yes, all of this lighting visually drawing your attention this way and away from whatever's going on over here. Because unless you actively turn away from these points of interest, only then will you see a way up onto the pier.
Yeah. And that's something that you will notice if you're coming back towards where you came from, and then you can explore that area.
Yeah, and so this is a theme that is kind of common in games in general, particularly pseudo-RPGs like this, where direct your attention to primary target, and then, later see other results.
Yeah.
But yeah, good point out of the ship over here, that will become relevant soon.
Yep.
And that's...
Not really soon.
Well, not soon, but...
Eventually.
That is another...
Foreshadowing.
This is a thing that this game does well, foreshadowing stuff in the future.
Speaking of foreshadowing...
Yeah, speaking of foreshadowing, let's go talk to Madame Foreshadowing.
So apparently she knows something about you.
You're happy. No. No, you are going to China.
Her dialogue is some of my favorite in the game.
Her dialogue is also some of the most important in the game.
Yeah. It's pretty good. What are you talking about?
Why is he smiling? the father? Is it the father behind him?
You're not making any sense.
You chased it for the one at the top of the city. On the sea. Oh, on the ground. You found it in a crypt. It's open. Oh, it's open. Oh god. Oh god. Run.
I don't understand.
I'm sorry. Sometimes I see nothing. Disregard what I say.
Come on, tell me more.
I don't know what I'm saying. Forget what I say.
You wanna do the first one?
Yeah.
Wait, do you know anything about the murder on the pier?
Yes. The killer is dead. He moves soon and travels to the heart of the Anhelis, to the home of the stars, and then returns fulfilled and empty once again.
Can you be so more specific?
I don't know what I'm saying. Forget what I say.
You want to pay her for a fortune?
We don't have a lot of cash right now.
That's true.
We may want to beat up the guys upstairs first.
Okay. Goodbye.
Yes. So, clearly this person knows what I'm up to. But also, if you caught the subtle visual cues, she is also a vampire.
Yep.
Got those pointy teeth. So what the hell is a vampire doing on the beach hanging out with all these fuckers?
And how does she know what's gonna happen to you?
Exactly. You see some guys?
I don't know. Talk to E. Guy without a shirt.
I'm gonna be a dick.
Okay. He just walks away.
Easy. No, walk.
Fucking mayhem, bro.
Do you know who the head vampire is?
Oh, who's the head vampire?
If the head vampire dies, we all become human again, right?
Oh. Only in the movies.
Oh. But how about blood transfusions? If I get a full blood transfusion, I can become human again, right?
No, I think it's permanent.
What? Oh, no. There's nothing I can do?
Yeah, sorry, good luck.
Tragedy.
If you want to be a dick to him, you can convince him to try to kill someone.
There's nothing I can do. I'm damned.
I'm not sure if... Yeah, I don't think you can now, but in the beginning you could be like, yeah, Dracula, go find him, and you lose humanity for it.
There's nothing I can do. I'm damned.
Ah, shit.
This sucks.
It's like I've told you types about 1,000 times now. We know we can't hang around here, alright? We're minding our own business. No reason to hassle the weaklings.
Weaklings? What does that mean?
I don't know, Corey. Why don't you tell us? Or let this gentleman explain.
How about we ask him about, no, what are you talking about?
You mean you ain't here to run us off?
No, why would you think that?
We're getting pretty sick of it. Someone's sighting the main, or in the worst case, is hunting us for sport.
What? Why?
Dunno. We all seem to have come down with the same disease. Who am I kidding? We're a bad horror show, all right? We seem to be the runts, the mistakes. You types call us thin bloods. I say we're all equally screwed.
Thin bloods? But what clan are you from?
Clan? See, I've heard all that before. And I still don't know what the hell anyone's talking about. I'd like to know just what I've become. We'd all like to know just what the hell kind of devil's contract we've apparently signed.
I
just come to town for the surf tournament. Seems like years ago, but it's been about 6 months now. Every night during the finals, I used to hit the local diner after the beach parties fizzled out in the AM. That's where I met her.
Met who?
She had a natural beauty. Not like all the plastic dolls littering the sand. Her name was Lily.
I remember introducing myself, the way she seemed grateful for the company. Well, a few nights after our meeting, we were on the beach alone.
Oh, go on.
She tried to tell me what she was, but I didn't understand. So she showed me. I was furious with her when I took it all in. I cursed her and left, never really knowing what I was. I realize now how she must have felt. So here I am now, a mystery to myself.
Is Lily dead?
Clinically, yes. But honestly, I don't know. I suppose I'd have moved on by now if I didn't think she'd show up one of these nights. There's a lot I've got left to say to her.
That's, what you asked her and what he says here has a bit of relation to what the other vampire who you just spoke to said to you. When you ask if she's dead, he says clinically yes, and that relates to some things that she said.
Yeah. Implying that the person who committed the murder is a vampire.
Yeah, because she says that that person is dead.
Yep.
So all the dialogues work off of each other.
Yes.
You do know you're vampires, right?
That's what Lily tried to tell me. But what I don't understand are the rules and the terms and the reason some of them are at our throats claiming we're harbingers of the apocalypse. That's what I want to know.
Are all these others here, Thin Bloods, as well?
Aye. Most of them just recently arrived in L.A. Were chased off by the Sabbath or some such thing from their home cities. More in the dark than I am. They're a good bunch, but I've been through a lot. It's affected them.
So Sabbath is a reference
to Sabbat, clearly.
Which we had learned about last episode.
Yes, the Sabbat. For those of you playing at home who haven't met the Sabbat before, we know that there are two broad vampire organizations that we have met. The Camarilla, who seem to be the
government,
and the Sabbat, who seem to be not that.
Yeah.
And they seem to be angry, crazy jerks.
Yep.
And the other person that we've met, a man by the name of Jack, who was
beautiful.
A rather jovial man who was showing us around and how to do the things and giving us a tutorial. He is implied that he does not think the Camarilla is good, but he likes the Sabbat even less.
Yes.
And he explains that in no uncertain terms.
And it seems the Sabbat have been,
messing with these Thin Bloods.
Yeah, messing with these people who are called Thin Bloods. Maybe I should look into this whole Thin Blood thing.
Hope you had better luck than I did. No one's been particularly friendly to me in this city. The only reason we're in Santa Monica is because we haven't been chased out yet.
I'll ask around and see what I can dig up.
Oh, we'd appreciate it. Oh, before I forget, name's Eve. The black-haired beauty over there is Rosa. She's the future, so she says. That nervous bloke is Copper. The one who can't speak so well is Julius. Kids laugh with him. They've had it rough.
Any idea where I might begin looking for information?
Seems no one will talk about it. It's all started that night in the diner. Maybe you can start there.
I'll see what I can do. Goodbye.
Sticking up at night.
Another subtle cue that these are vampires, but not. Like, they're different. If we look at ourselves by hitting Z, we are gray as shit.
Yeah.
We look like we are... We are very gray, and all the vampires we've met to this point are very gray. These lot are noticeably not gray. Like, they're all normal human skin tones.
Yep, and they also, for some reason, don't know what clan they are, which you knew immediately, and people kind of identify themselves with their clan, but for some reason these people who are Thin Bloods, you can go ahead, do not know what clan they are.
Ooh. Entering combat area.
Oh boy. Here we go. Fisticuffs.
Fisticuffs, possibly. Or other solutions, possibly.
Time to go look for some Astrolite. Oh, who is this?
Help you.
Yes.
Oh, I'm absolutely going to seduce my way out of this problem.
Do I look dangerous to you? I'm sure a big man like you isn't scared of me.
I tell you what, I'll let you in. If on your way out, you want to work out a little fair trade for future purchases,
wait.
Come see Brian.
Hi, Brian. I'll think about that, Brian. See ya.
So, how do we want to skin this particular cat? Because I know that there are several ways out of this problem.
Yeah. Maybe you should save first.
Yeah, let's save. Saving is a good idea.
Let's just...
Actually, I may have wiped out one of my old saves. Oops. Okay, saved.
Good. Let's walk in and see what happens.
Yeah.
I mean, he let you in, didn't he?
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, there's a guy here. He's watching something.
He's playing a video game. Oh, no. A man playing with floating cards. Like you do. Lifting weights, yeah.
Bathroom. Oh, computer.
Oh, we don't have enough power of the computer.
Try blood buff. Blood buff.
We're low on blood, though. Do we take the risk?
We could...
Pound down some blood.
Oh yeah, we have blood bags.
Yeah. We could blood Estus. Ah. Pound down the useful Estus flasks. And then we're gonna blood buff our way through this problem. Oof. Almost ran out of blood buff before I did that. Oh, actually, that didn't work.
Well, I guess we can't, look in that, then.
Yeah. I think it's perception that, does.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, well.
Alright. Go through here. And I can go to your right.
Ah.
Oh. So hidden. What's in here? Oh, it's the money!
Take the money. Now we have another way we can do this.
So this is you have to be kind of aware of your surroundings here. So you wouldn't get the money unless you really were looking for it.
Also, if you were unable to convince Chad.
Oh, they got a puppy. This is new.
Oh yeah, no. Check this out. This way has been here.
Well, I knew about this, but I didn't know about the dog.
Yeah.
Don't do it because that'll set him off.
That's true.
Oh, hello! Hi, Puffer.
Hello, Doge friend.
So, there are different ways you can be sneaky about it and, like, sneak through. You can just go in guns blazing. Or you can try to convince them to let you in, which is what we did.
Yeah.
And so, obviously...
Yeah, that is what I love about this business. Fine women come to my house for my shit. I don't even gotta call them on the phone or nothing. Say there, pretty lady. What can I hook you up with tonight?
So, this guy is very, he is quite obviously looks different than everyone else. They all have hoodies with their hoods up, and this guy has some sort of coat on, and he's white, whereas they are all dull colors, and,
He's wearing white and red and gold.
Yeah.
He, like, visually stands out.
Yeah.
Clearly telegraphing, I am in charge. And he plays on visual cues from, like, the 70s and 80s. Particularly from a certain kind of movie. Like, noir movies? Like, L.A. Confidential? Like, this game. Like, pro tip for those of you who weren't here last time, my thesis is that this game is an expert class in how to make a noir video game.
You have a couple theses.
I do have several theses about this game. But main one is that this is like, this is probably one of the most noir video games that has been made.
It's really good. What have you got?
My staff maintains at all times a 24-karat smorgasbord of A-plus narcotics guaranteed to make the competition shit seem like a weak cappuccino in comparison. White, green, blues, reds, black, you pick a color.
So, what do we do? Do we bring up Mercurio, knowing that they beat him up? Or do we try to play it cool?
Let's play cool.
Okay. I'm looking for something different. Got any explosives?
Explosives? Fun stuff. You can get yourself a lot of attention that way. I may have something. Why would you need to get your hands on some fireworks?
Oh, which one? Number four?
Yeah.
May want to watch the news tonight.
Yeah.
Okay. I got some stuff that'll do the trick. Acetonite. It's like TNT's bigger, meaner cousin with a prison record. I don't like keeping the stuff around. Too dangerous. So I'll let you have it for a little less than the going rate.
Anything else you can take besides cash?
Yeah. Always choose seduce.
Yes, obviously.
I'd be open to negotiations. Question is, how open are you?
Very.
Yo, go check the odometer on my car. Now, I'll give you what you want, but I got what you need.
Let me show you a new trick I picked up.
So, before we do this, do we intend to kill him?
That is a good question. Do we intend to kill him? I think... And that's kind of that's an interesting question. I say... No?
Let's not. Let's try not killing him.
Let's try not killing him.
Let me show you a new trick I picked up.
Yeah. Nom 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 nom.
Yeah, he's pretty good quality.
Yeah, he is pretty good quality blood.
There. Now while he's stunned, grab the Astrolite and go!
Got out of her.
Go! I think that they might... No.
I don't think they unstun.
Good. Run! Oh, okay, Brian.
Yeah, Brian. See, here's another thing of note. When I was doing my test playthrough of this, if you... don't want to fall down. My test playthrough of this a few days ago, it is worth noting that if you're a Bruja and implied have a higher presence and I guess are implied to be more attractive, he responds to you differently than if you're Tremere.
Tremere or Toreador?
Tremere.
Really?
Like when I first entered and he's like, see, I love this job. Pretty women come to me. Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
As this Bruja character. As a Tremere character, I come and he's like, yeah, here's the fucking deal. No, I'm not gonna deal with, like, I demand fucking cash. Mm. I don't want to negotiate with your junkie ass.
Yeah.
And no trying to pull any funny stuff, or I have no problem blowing your ass away.
Let's go to... do you want to ask her for your future or not? Also, are we planning on giving Mercurio the money or keeping it?
I think we are planning on giving Mercurio the money, because let's be nice.
Okay.
Let's be nice to Mercurio. He was nice to us.
Then we can come back to her later.
I actually really like this song.
So, you can go ahead and head wherever.
Actually, this choice of song, I think, is significant, particularly that Rose's resting position is next to
Tragedy.
It. The song is Smaller God. The main refrain that you can understand is, but I hear the voice of a smaller god.
Oh, interesting.
I think it's an interesting choice with Rosa being around. Does the chat have any interesting questions
for us? Tom just said, let him buy his organs. I thought I was going to say something, but I forget. Keep going.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you do try to fight your way through that, it's hard. It's really difficult to fight through those people.
I had some problem as Tremere, but I remember playing This Is Bruja before and just...
Oh, I never played as Bruja, so I guess.
Oh, yeah. The fights are so much easier as Bruja. You just, like, punch your way. Like, see, the direct solution isn't always the best solution unless you're Bruja, in which case you just punch a hole through your problems.
I remember what I was going to say.
Silent.
The thing that you mentioned about Tremere, that plays with the idea that Tremere are specifically strange and make people very uncomfortable, including vampires.
Yep. Well, and it's also kind of more of that, the game. I think that's a subtle but brilliant choice in game design.
Yeah, and there's a lot of stuff that happens that way, where your how you are clan-wise
affects how people perceive you.
Yeah. Is he dead?
No, he's still moving.
He's alive! Mercurio?
Or do... Aw, damn.
Yeah. Aw, damn, did you die on me? I brought you some morphine. Hold still.
Hold still, I put it in you.
Oh, holy Christ, I needed that.
Yeah, the bolustus.
Yeah, and I always wondered why you didn't give him your blood.
That's a good question. Maybe he wouldn't have taken it.
Yeah. I got the astrolite back.
Yeah? Did you waste those sons of bitches?
No, that's not my style.
Did you get my money back?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, you're a lifesaver. I might have to buy some new kidneys with this.
That's $250.
What's the story with the astrolite?
That astrolite? Twice as powerful as TNT. Instant demolition. Be on the other side of the world when you engage that timer. You need to make someplace disappear. A warehouse. Looks to be a Sabbat interest.
Oh, the Sabbat's coming back again.
Mm-hmm.
And we could see that the prince, who Mercurio works for, has an interest in hindering the Sabbat.
Making the Sabbat go away. So.
How do I find this place?
There's a guy. I never met him, but I heard a lot about him. His name is Tong. Bertram Tong. He's one of you types. If there's anyone who knows more than me about this city, it's him.
One of us types.
Unfortunately, Tong's hiding out at the moment.
What? Why?
Tong's laying low because of Therese. Therese Vorman, you know her? Anyway, word is Therese and Tong are feuding. I don't know the details. My take's that Tong thinks he's about to get whacked, so he's gone underground till Therese calls it off. If you want to put that warehouse into orbit anytime soon, you're gonna have to get Therese to call off the feud.
Where can I find her?
She and her sister, Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place. I try not to do business there.
What can you tell me about her?
She's the woman around here. Power player. Nice looking broad for a dead chick, but, personality like stone.
Had a question about someone else.
Who exactly?
Jeanette.
Therese I don't like, but I can respect her. Jeanette's different. I don't know what to make of her. She's a little, you know, in the head. I don't know. Therese is, well, like you. And I would think so is Jeanette. But I hear rumors about her.
Rumors?
Call me old-fashioned, but I just can't talk about that kind of thing in front of a woman.
I wonder what he says to a dude.
I've never actually played a dude in this game,
either.
So I have no idea.
Because the male character models are gross.
Yeah.
Well, this dude, number one, call me old-fashioned, but I believe a knee to the balls always makes a guy talk.
All right. Jeanette got a body built for bedrooms. And I got close acquaintances says they conquered that territory. But I asked the main man, and he says you types, you know, can't or don't or do that kind of thing. Anyway, whatever she is, I hear Jeanette's a wild girl.
That also, the way that Mercurio just spoke to you also, is a hint to his, well, I guess not a hint because you already know, but is indicative of his age.
Yeah.
He's really showing his age with that.
Yeah, that's like, call me old fashioned, and then she's got a body built for bedrooms, and doesn't he say broad in there at some point?
I think at some point, yeah.
My question's about someone else.
Yep.
Who exactly?
Bertram.
I don't know him myself. I'd like to meet the guy. Kind of a local legend. He and Therese seem to be contenders for this city. He's crafty. Smart guy. I haven't heard anything bad about him.
I had other questions about people.
Who exactly?
You.
What's to tell? I can get anything anyone wants at any time. I could say it's my calling. Until the Astrolite. Wasn't anything I couldn't handle. Well, back east some shit went down. Big Apple can't go back. I hate L.A., but what are you gonna do?
You said something about blood?
Right. You're straight off the bus. Once a month I get fed vampire blood. Heals me faster. Makes me stronger than a normal human.
Oh yeah, you did say that already. I had other questions about Santa Monica.
Specifically?
Tell me about some of the power players.
He
kind of already said that. Yeah. Where I can score some guns.
Guns? Guy named Trip up the street. He keeps a few pieces under the table, but he didn't sell to anybody. Doesn't have a license. I'll give him a call. He'll sell to you. It's the least I can do.
What is the chat asking us?
Tom and Jamila were speaking about game design and how he treats you differently depending on your gender.
Yeah. I actually do think that's interesting design. I wish I knew what the other side of that was. That had never actually occurred to me to...
Tom just said he just tells you if you're a guy.
Huh. See, that's little touches about this game that I like. That your identity as an RPG character, which we don't see often affect you. Even in more modern games with a lot of resources, you don't see your identity as a character, your identity as a person affect you very often.
And Vampire the Masquerade, even generally as a system, is really good at that. At how it helps, especially in the live tabletop games that you can play. It kind of helps a GM figure out how people will interact with you too.
And I think like that's great advertising for the this game is performing great advertising for the tabletop game.
Yeah.
But also
the best.
That's something that you rarely see in video games. Like Elder Scrolls occasionally does that, but even they don't do it with near the like subtlety. Like it's usually they telegraph it when they do it, whereas VTM kind of is a little more subtle with how they make characters react to you differently.
Yeah, so go back a little bit. So you leave Mercurio again, and you're not really sure what to do. You already went, you came from this way, you went this way already, so, what is this peeking out right in front of you?
Yeah, well, and if you've wandered around before, it's almost impossible not to notice this sign, because it's a bright light at the end. There's red flashing light at the end of this alleyway. There's a bright light. Depending on how you have skinned the hospital problem, you may have already been down that way through an exit there to get to this. We've seen asylum posters all over the place, so clearly this is some place of importance that we want to go. The asylum.
Here's a whole nother space in
Ta-da.
The game.
Foxy boxes. Which, spoiler alert, not a brothel. I thought it, every time I play this game, if there's a long gap between plays, I keep thinking it's a brothel.
Really?
Yeah, because I always forget what's in there.
There's a woman on the sign, so.
Yeah, I'm like, oh yeah. And Foxy Boxes. That sounds incredibly innuendo-y.
The asylum.
The asylum. This looks like a place. Hey, buddy. Ooh, 9 people. Saucy. So, we go to meet 2 of my favorite people.
What do we have here? Another scrumptious young plaything straight out of life and into my club? You smell new, little girl. Like fabric softener do on freshly mowed AstroTurf. Oh, I'm not frightening you, am I, duckling?
Always flirt.
Yes. Frightening isn't the word I'd use. Exciting is more like it.
I can tell you and I are going to get along just like fire hoses.
Fire hoses?
When we get turned on, there's bound to be flames.
Who are you?
I'm the finger down your spine when all the lights are out. And the name on all the names on the walls. When I pout, the whole world tries to make me smile. And everyone always wants to know who is that girl.
Aren't you a tease?
I am Jeanette. And this bit of chaos crammed in a certifiable giggle is my club. I just love to give you funny feelings all night, sweetheart, but I really must trouble with some business. We'll reunite Sweden soon, I promise.
Soon can't come enough. Soon enough. Goodbye. The physics, though. Look at this stupid walking! So bad. Okay. So.
Let me turn this down a little so I can hear you.
That was a woman named Jeanette, who we were just told about by Mercurio. So it seems that Jeanette owns this club called the Asylum.
With her sister, Therese, who we have also been informed of.
We have not met.
Who we have not met.
And we just saw Jeanette leave and go upstairs.
Which kind of implies that that's where we're supposed to be going.
Yeah.
Once again, another case of this game not trusting its own design.
Yeah, I think that it's because they fell a little flat with how they designed it, because you wouldn't be able to see her do that with how you're standing and how it's designed. I think that they probably should have positioned her a little bit different.
Like, positioned her here more?
Yeah, so that you could watch her walk.
That's true, and I think that that this is partially, like, this game does a lot of things that I think that they weren't sure were going to land, and so they undercut themselves a lot. My friend wants us to go dance on the stage. This is actually one of my favorite pastimes in this game.
Oh, yeah. You know, if you do it long enough, you, gain humanity? Either you gain humanity or something else.
Yeah, I think you do. And this is the best club to do it in, because none of the NPCs here have an auto line, like they do in other clubs we shall go to in the future, which can get annoying.
Look at the dance moves, though.
Yeah.
And they all dance around you in a circle.
Yeah, you're a popular person.
Yeah. Well, you can go ahead. Yeah. You probably should get the humanity when you don't need it. So let's follow.
Follow? I have a thought here, because this guy is... This is why I don't think, like, necessarily doing the cutscene is the smartest move. I think they probably did it because they also wanted to control how Jeanette loaded in the scene. Because perhaps they were having technical difficulties with how... making characters disappear in transition. But, I mean, that might be correct. But this guy, he's right in our line of sight. Like, he's the first person we see other than Jeanette.
And he's obviously an employee.
Yeah. I don't trace.
You sure? I think you need Bloody Mary.
I'm sure you do. A big man like you must have lots of talent.
Yes.
I'll be there, Big Cal. First, I need you to tell me where I can find Therese.
Therese? She's upstairs. She said she had business to attend to, but I can hear her and Jeanette bickering from here. Why do you need to see her?
I need to talk to her.
Yeah, yeah, I hear that from everyone, sweetheart. She expected you or something.
That's it. She's expecting me.
All right, look, I'll cut you a break because we're busy here. I'll buzz Therese, tell her you're coming. Take the elevator over there up. But if I hear that you're not supposed to be there, you and me are gonna have an all hard time. Do you hear me?
Thanks. Goodbye. So, we learn that Therese is upstairs, and Jeanette just went upstairs and they're fighting.
Yep. So they do not like each other. Oh, look!
Oh! Our buddy!
Our buddy Knox! On his secret mission.
Oh, yes. Very secretive. That he told us about. Hey, Knox. What's going on?
Yeah, not much. Just waiting around for my master.
The master you can talk about?
Okay. I guess I can tell you about it.
Oh, man! His name's Bertram Tung! He's a Nosferatu.
Oh.
Uh-huh. So, Bertram Tung, who Mercurio says, smart, sneaky, clever, has a guy who we have seen is not subtle thus far, and has been both at the hospital and here. That's interesting.
And we also learned that Bertram is a Nosferatu. An educated attention and character creation. We saw that Nosferatus were the clan that were super scary.
They look literally like the Nosferatu from the movie, so buggo. Seriously bad, like car accident kind of bad.
No kidding. Small world, I'm looking for him.
Where he is, or stays, or anything.
What is Bertram like? Or do you want to do number two?
Let's do number two.
Yeah. What do you mean, just appears?
Just appears out of, like, in the air. First time, bam! I think he got that heart attack. Especially how he works.
The first time? Why did he choose you?
Bertram says he needed someone to listen to. Man, he must be working with a giant bird for a while. Man, it's so cool. It's like a child he knows, man. It's like live forever and stuff.
And nothing's about him either.
Yeah.
Can you tell me what he has you doing?
Oh, man. My Bertram. Asian dude who's been poking around Santa Monica. So thought he might be a vampire or something like a vampire. I don't know.
Tell me about this Asian dude.
Oh man, this guy, this thing got wise to me. Now instead of me watching him, he's watching me, you know? I see this guy and me around me all the time. Like, I'm in the distance watching him warm up next to me.
So, should we offer to help?
Yes.
Want me to take care of it?
Hell yeah! Right on! Like I said, he's some kind of vampire. Who like that? Describe it to us. He's so freaked out that I haven't had a chance to check it out.
driver's license that tells you who he is?
No. The picture on the license is legit. I don't know why you had it. I'd love to find out what he's doing.
Alright, I'll take care of it. Sounds good enough. What's Bertram like? How does he get in touch with you?
It's crazy! It just appears out of like thin air! First time! Bam! I can see you got that heart attack!
Oh man, especially how he looks.
We already asked that. Good.
So,
Knox is on his special mission that we are now on.
Would you like to take this chance to talk while I give us some stats?
Stats?
Because we have unspent...
Oh, yes. Okay. So, Knox just told us a little bit about Bertram, who is his master, and he is a ghoul for. We also learned that Bertram is an Osferatu, and Bertram sent Knox, who used to be a bounty hunter, on a secret mission. Oh, they can't hear us very well when the club music gets loud.
Yeah, sorry about that.
We can probably fix that in options.
Yeah, let's work on that, actually.
Audio?
No. No, we have no way of fixing that. Yeah, okay. This is a pretty loud club. Don't worry, we will not be here for
very long.
All time.
And Knox also.
Let's actually. Actually, I'll do this when we are alone. Actually, I think I can do this.
Yeah, it's fine. So Knox mentions to us that there is this, quote, Asian guy, unquote. That he was following, and I was following him. He says that this guy is some sort of Asian vampire, which, if we were paying attention in character creation, nowhere does it say that any of the clans are specifically from Asia. So this is something, or any of the playable clans. So this is some sort of vampire clan or something else that is unknown to us at this time, and it's something that we are now going to be looking into.
Also, there was a missed opportunity for us to call him out on stuff, because we did not have an appropriate enough stat.
Yeah.
Do you want me to explain that to you, Dishy?
Like, you can get more information out of him earlier if you have certain stats.
And you can also figure out that he is not there by accident. That he is intentionally following you.
Last time I looked, it was called Santa Monica, not stuck up bitch. So vulgar. I can't even look at you sometimes.
Jezebel.
Oh, please. You really do paint a flattering portrait of me with your turn-of-the-century barb. I always assumed you could do nothing but look down on me.
Just the sight of you. The sight of that wicked painted pout, concealing that dirty, diseased mind. Sin! You have no sin. Let's see who is without sin, past the fierce tone. Go ahead and mock me. You pull your pranks, make fun of my ways. It suits you. You're just one big joke. Don't you call me that.
Should I start calling a duck a pig as well?
I'm your sister. How can you treat me like this?
That's it, Jeanette. Run away from the truth. I'll take care of everything, as always.
Huh. So, some arguing going on. And yeah. A shiny.
A shiny! My shiny! The LA Sun.
Now here's...
The Carnival of Death.
Yeah,
that's in case we have successfully managed to avoid it up to this point.
Yeah, which we have, kind of.
I mean, well...
Except at the end.
Let's go see Therese, the other Vorman sister.
Yep. There she is.
Please, come in. I do apologize for my sister's crassness if it made you uncomfortable. She's unabashedly scandalous, but in the club business, I suppose that kind of personality is a necessary evil.
How do you want to act towards, Jeanette? Oh, God. I'm sorry. How do you want to act towards Therese?
I think we should be nice to Therese. She hasn't been mean to us.
Okay. Do you want to say number one or number two?
I think... let's say three.
Okay.
She's no trouble.
Nonsense. She's nothing but.
Okay.
Are you... Therese?
Therese Vorman, yes. I'm the proprietor of this club, and the only person in this city whose good side it's in your best interest to stay on. What brings you to Santa Monica?
You gotta call off that feud, though.
Yeah, that feud.
Tongue's exile is self-imposed, I assure you. But then, what reason would I have not to hate that loathsome Nosferatu scoundrel?
Racism.
Lucky Nosferatu. They're so unclean.
Racism within vampire society.
There's a lot of it.
Yes. Why do you hate him?
He meddles in my affairs. He's a bad influence on my sister and she on him. If you were in my place, would you let him compromise your authority? You most certainly would not. I'd quite like it if I never had to hear that name again.
Then
can you put out the word that you've got no feud with him?
Why would I do that? Let him think I mean to kill him. That way I don't have to worry about him sabotaging everything. Do you realize how his subterfuge makes me look to the Camarilla?
That's unfortunate.
Yep.
But I do need to see him.
Tongue and his co-conspirators' actions ruined my chance at partnership in a crucial piece of property. I do have several other promising ventures. And one in particular has been, to say the least, an ordeal. I'd be willing to put the word out that my grievances with Tongue have been swept under the rug, but in return, you'll have to help me remove a particularly burdensome spirit from a property I'm looking to invest in.
Ghosts? A spirit? You mean a ghost?
Ghosts! Not the ghosts!
I forgot. You're still new to this. Allow me to break you in. Yes, ghosts exist. Werewolves, mummies, and I'd expect a whole lot of other things I've never seen share the night with us.
Uh-oh.
Two.
Yeah, sure, I'll do it. What do I have to get rid of? What do I have to do to get rid of the ghost?
Rumor is that a personal item of a ghost may be used to draw it out or excise it from its haunt. While I don't put a lot of stock in hearsay, it's my last option. So I want you to go to the Ocean House Hotel, find an item of the spirits, and bring it back.
I'll do it if you promise I can to call off the feud.
Oh, I fully intend to do so. You'll find that dealing with me on the whole is appreciably more predictable than dealing with some of the egomaniacs that are my peers. So long as our business doesn't go sour, my word is gold.
Two. I can respect that and appreciate it. Goodbye.
Before I forget, take this. The only way to reach the Ocean House this time of night is through a tunnel in the sewers. You'll need that key to open the gate for that tunnel.
If that's what it takes to get the job done.
If you'll excuse me, I've got situations to set straight.
You want to ask her questions?
Yeah, sure, okay. Why not?
I had a few questions. She mad. Tell me about your sister.
Jeanette is the freak show I keep around to lure in curiosity seekers. She's very good with the clientele, but her business skills are approximate to those of a 4-year-old with a $1 bill and a 5 and dime.
Ah, I'm glad we sit to ask questions. But we'll get to that after the questions. Questions to bounce off of you. Why do you hate Bertram Chung?
I think we already asked that.
Oh, that's right.
I think that's it.
Okay. So, she's got the skills of a 4-year-old with a dollar and a with a $5 bill and a 5 and dime. No one calls dollar stores 5 and dimes anymore. And with Jeanette yelling at her about her antiquated insults, we have now dated Therese Vorman.
Yes. And we already know that she is a vampire, and so is Jeanette. We learn that with Mercurio.
Yeah. But this is a thing that is a recurring theme for most of the vampires or older ghouls that we see, where they have, in some ways, they talk like we do now, but their voices are not their voices, their form of speech.
They speak in antiquated terms.
Yeah, like they're struggling with reality. Also, I like the way that their room is set up. So you have sober, serious Therese Vorman.
Yep.
And then you have Jeanette.
Obviously. And we heard... Oh, okay, let's do this first then. Two girls and a man in the middle. It's huge!
Yeah.
Huge painting. And this is kind of what you see as one of the last things when you look around the room. Because it is to your back.
Yeah.
But it is there, and, like, you are right next to it if you are just talking to Therese, mm-hmm. and then you look around, and it, bam, it hits you in the face.
Yeah, and, like, this is important imagery for their characters. So, they are clearly divided by... And the implicit use of a division associated in perfect line with this, the center of this painting.
And it's also interesting... Because the implication is that Jeanette is on the right in this painting, and Therese is on the left in this painting because of the pigtails.
Yeah.
But they are on the wrong sides in the room.
Yeah. And they are, like... But I also like this imagery of the crooked fence here, or the crooked partition,
mm-hmm.
Dividing along this line. So it's, like, clearly there is a split... between them, and it is related to this painting, and the figure in the center of this painting is this older man.
Yep. And, try to go check on Jeanette.
Yes, let's go check on the Jeanette.
Because we heard, oh, it's locked, well, and you can't open it.
She's locked herself into the bathroom.
And you heard that when they were arguing before.
Yep.
Girls rock.
Guns.
Just guns.
Guns don't kill, people do. Rock me Amadeus, hey!
Should we wrap it for today? I think this is a good spot.
Do you think this is a good spot?
Yeah.
I think this is a good spot.
I agree. Well, it was my idea, so.
Yes!
I agree with myself.
I'm glad that you agree with yourself, and I am glad that we got as far as meeting the Vormans.
Yes, me too.
Yes. Alright, so let us... this has been The Play's the Thing.
Yep.
And we hopefully caught some King's consciences.
Consciences.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
With... these plays, and I hope we caught your consciences too. Hey, and I hope you had a good time in listening to us talk about words and noises and sounds.
Yep, and figures.
And figures.
And colors.
And colors and shapes.
Yeah. So thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks for watching. We'll be back next week.
Yep, probably.
Same bat time, same bat channel. So goodbye, delicious human friends.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Stop them.